Hello students, in this video we are going to continue reading and learning the second part of chapter 11, 704th EVS. We had read till page 83 and I had explained in that we saw about Ratan who had visited her grandfather's place, village, and there she saw many different kinds of plants in his orchard. And we came to know about different flowers, what are the uses of the flowers, and what do we get, what different kind of things we get from flowers. Now, let us continue reading further. So, this is the 84th page of your textbook. Let's begin reading. Let us know some more. Have you ever seen anyone selling flowers anywhere? If there are any flowers nearby, ask them these questions and write. So, a person who sells flowers is known as a florist. What are the flowers that they sell? That means they can be selling rose, lilies, and marigolds, such flowers. So, you have to ask the florists, what kind of flowers do they sell? The next question, from where do they bring these flowers? Now, the answer to this question can be from a garden or from a horticulture farm. A horticulture farm is a place where they grow flowers. So, there are two places from where they can get flowers, and you can be expecting any one of these answers. Or if they visit certain marketplaces, such as there is a huge market of flowers in Dadar station. So if they might be getting flowers from those markets, then that will also be part of your answer. The next question can be, why do people buy flowers? Now, people buy flowers for decorations, to give gifts, they buy bouquets to give gifts on different occasions, and for worship, to put on the altar of God. So, there are different purposes to buy flowers. In what form do florists sell their flowers? Look at these pictures. Mark against those forms of flowers that you have seen. Now, flowers can be sold in many different forms. It can be sold as a string, such as this. It can be sold as a bouquet, as a basket of flowers. So, there are different ways in which the florists sell flowers. So, you can mark the type of mode of flowers that these florists sell. This activity has to be done in your textbooks. Now, they can sell the strings of flowers, they can sell bouquets of flowers, they can sell, even some people buy petals of flowers to do decorations such as this. Now, to make this decoration, they need only petals of flowers. So, they can, people also sell these loose petals. The next question is, have you seen any other form of flower than this? So, yes, there is gajras. Ladies wear gajras on their head, especially in southern states. So, flowers can be also sold in the form of gajra. Some flowers are used in different forms, like rose and marigolds are used in garlands and as loose petals too. So as I said before, that loose petals are also sold instead of garlands and bouquets. Find out the price of these different forms of flowers. So now, when you go to a florist to ask such information, you can also ask the price. Now, one flower may cost you 5 rupees or maybe 10 rupees. One garland can cost you maybe 10 to 20 rupees, and one bouquet may cost you 50 to 100 rupees. It depends on the size of the bouquet and on the size of the garland. The next question is, has the florist learned to make bouquets or a net of flowers from anybody, from whom? So they might learn this technique from their elders or from some people whom they know and whom they might have asked to teach them. So there are different modes, different people from whom they can learn to make bouquets and flowers and garlands, but especially, more preferably, they learn from their elders. The next question is, would they, like the other members of their family, to do this work? Why? So yes, they would like to teach this to their other members of their family because it provides good income. This is also a source of income. People do not make garlands just to enjoy or just because they like making garlands, but selling garland is also a good business. So it can be taught to their family members and other members too, so that they can also earn money out of making garlands and bouquets. Now here is a small activity which is given, in which you have to collect the dry leaves or dry flowers from your place around your house, and you have to put it under the newspaper and press it and make like a scrapbook out of the dried flowers. And you can also make a card for someone out of these dried flowers. So that is the activity which is explained over here. So if you like, you can do this activity at home. Now here what happens, that Ratan is walking ahead in the orchard and she saw some person was cleaning grass in the corner of the field. She went there and started pulling the grass. Now what is going to happen? Ratan is a small girl. Her hands are soft. So what will happen? That her hands will get hurt while pulling grass. So is written over here. And many roots also came out when she was pulling the grass out. Now, can you tell that every plant has roots? So yes, every plant has roots. Look at some trees and plants near you. How deep and wide its roots are. Imagine. Now imagine means you have to think about how deep those roots might have gone. There Ratan saw that Ramji Bhai was pulling radish. Ratan asked Ramji Bhai, so he told, Beta, these are radish and it is also roots. Suddenly rain started. It was raining heavily with storm. However, the trees were stood still. So how come the trees were standing still? These questions might arise her mind. Why the tree did not fall despite of heavy winds? Imagine. Now the trees did not fall despite of heavy rain because the roots of the trees have gone way below in the soil and they are holding the soil very firmly, and that's why it gives the trees strength to stand straight even though when the wind blows very heavily. Why do the withered leaves of growing plants become fresh when they are watered? Withered means the dried leaves of plants become fresh when they are watered because the thirsty roots of the plants, they get fresh water and it gives them kind of energy to rekindle themselves and to brighten themselves. And that is why even if the plant has grown little dry, that means withered, if you pour water in the plant can grow again. Now here is a question, which plants around you need regular watering? So plants, delicate plants such as rose plant, aloe vera plant, money plant, these plants need regular watering. Ratan also came to know that she had not given water to the neem tree, which was grown near her house. She thought how the neem tree will get water then. So neem tree is a huge plant, a big plant, and its roots have gone way below inside the soil, and it can get water from the earth itself, because when it rains, the earth stores water down below inside the soil, and the roots of the tree, huge tree such as neem tree and mango tree, they get water from those roots, from the depths of the earth. So it is not necessary for us to water those plants regularly like we water rose plant or aloe vera plant or money plant. Now, which plants nearby you did not require water regularly? How do they get water? So this is what I explained, like trees like mango tree, guava tree and lemon tree, they do not require regular watering. Now look at the pictures of vegetables given below and find out which one are roots from them. So you are smart enough, you know which ones are roots. So you have to tick the vegetables which are roots from this, such as radish and beetroot and carrot. Okay, so do it by yourself in your textbook. Ratan would have many questions about plants now. She saw the plant growing out from the wall of school. So there were some plants which were growing out of the wall of the school. She was surprised. She thought how deep the roots of these plants would go. How will the roots get water? So she was thinking about those plants also. Now these plants which grow on the wall, they take the support of the wall and grow, and these plants are known as creepers because they creep on the walls and take support of such things like other trees, walls, sticks, these kind of things they have to take support to grow because their branches are very weak. So here are some questions that arise in Ratan's mind, that how big will these plants be, what would happen to this wall, and can you tell the name of the plant in the picture? Now the plant in the picture which is here, it looks like a rose plant, the wild rose which grows, or such plant like that. And what will happen, how big will this plant grow? It will not grow very big like mango tree or neem tree. And what will happen to this wall? This wall will be covered with the branches, the veins of this plant. And can you tell the name of the plant that I already said? Have you seen a plant growing out from the cracks of the walls like this? Which question arises in your mind? Know the answer from your elders and note down. Now, if you have seen such plants growing out of the wall, you can write about that. Now, Ratan had seen a huge tree fallen down at the edge of the field. She recalled the neem tree of her school. She can see the damaged roots of that tree. She thought, has somebody pulled out this tree or it fell down itself? How old would this tree be? How will the tree get water from between the rocks at the edge of the field? So these are all the questions that arise in her mind. Now, which are the old trees in your area? How old are they? Know from your elders. So you have to ask your grandparents about the oldest tree in your area, and you have to write the name of the tree, and you have to ask approximately how old that tree might be. Then write the names of animals living on this tree. So there might be living some squirrels, some different birds like sparrows and parrots. So you have to write their names over here. Now, have you seen any huge tree fallen down? What did you think when you saw it? So, if you have seen any huge tree fallen down, the first question that arises in your mind would be that, how did this tree fall down? Because of the storm, because it was too old, because the insects might have eaten the tree from within. There are many possibilities. Now, strange, freaky, weird roots. Have you ever swung on banyan tree? What did you hold to swing? How do the hanging branches look like? This is the root of banyan tree. It is called prop or aerial roots. So, the roots by which you swing on a banyan tree are known as aerial roots. So, there is not just banyan tree, but there are other trees also who have such roots. It grows from the branches and touches the ground. Kabirwad, situated in the Bharuch, is very big. Its prop aerial roots are giving strength to the banyan tree like pillars now. Remember one thing, that banyan tree has the roots inside the soil like other trees. Have you seen prop aerial roots growing from other trees like banyan tree? If you have seen, you can mention it over here. Now here is an activity in which you have to soak some seeds of green gram or wheat or bajra or mustard, such as these, okay? You have to soak it overnight, and then you have to place a bunch of cotton on the glass, and you have to make it little wet, and after making it wet, you have to put those soaked seeds on the cotton, and remember to keep the cotton little moist, wet, so that it gets the sprouts which you have kept, the seeds which you have kept on the cotton, they may get moisture, good moisture and water to grow. And after 10 to 12 days, you will observe that sprouts means small branches will be coming out of the seeds. So you have to observe those seeds. Now, when these seeds grow into small sprouts, that process is known as germination. So you have to observe how these seeds germinated, and then you have to paste picture of the seeds from day 4 and day 8 in your textbook. Now, have you observed the changes in the soaked seeds? Compare them with the dried seeds and ripe. So the color of the seeds might have changed, and small leaves must be coming out of the seed. So those are the changes about which you can write. What would happen if the cotton got dried? What will happen if the cotton got dried? Yes, the seeds will not get moisture and they will not grow. They will not germinate properly. In which direction the root and the stems grow? So the root grows downwards, the stem grows upwards. Next, how much will be the growth of the plant in the piece of cotton? So it will have grown, but not very much. Now, has the sapling come out from every seed? So it is not necessary that the sapling comes out of every seed. Some seed might not have got proper moisture and it might be left dried and as it was before. What is the color of the root? So it can be brown or white. You can write it over here. After you observe the seeds which you have kept to get sprouted, okay, to get germinated. So according to your observation, you have to write the details over here. And have you seen any root hairs on the root? So about that too, you can write. Usually you see root hair on the rice roots. Next is, try to pull a small plant from cotton. Are you able to pull it? Why? No, when you try to pull out, it is not coming out easily because the roots have gone deep in the cotton. They have taken hold of cotton because through cotton they are getting moisture. Same way, the roots of the plant also take hold of the soil because they get moisture from the soil. Do you see how firmly the roots hold the cotton? Think that roots are holding the land also firmly like this. Look at the plant which your friend has grown. So you have to observe your plant as well as your friend's plant. Next is, what is grown? Arifa and Rupali did the above activity. When asked, they saw the grown grass. What did they grow? They have different idea for the grown things. Arifa made this list: leaves, neem seed, bud, puppy, nails, fish. Moon, tree, eye, hair, watermelon, mosquito, crow, etc. are there in Rupali's name. What do you think, which things will grow from the list of Arifa and Rupali? So, which things will grow? So, you have to think out of these which things are able to grow. So, the moon, will the moon grow? Yes or no? The moon grows and it also gets smaller in size, but actually the size of the moon is same, so we cannot say that the moon grows. Same way, leaves they grow as the plant grows, so yes, that will grow. Neem seed, yes, that will grow in size. Bud will grow into a flower, puppy will grow into a dog, and our nails also grow, and fish will also grow. So all these things in Arifa's list will grow. Then, except moon, the rest of the things in Rupali's list will grow. What do you think, which thing will grow from the list of Arifa and Rupali? We already discussed that. Then, why don't you create your own list of the things which can grow? You can add the things from Arifa and Rupali's list in your list. So you have to make a list of the things that grow. Think of yourself. How many changes come with time in you also? Have you grown in any way? For example, does your height increase? How tall are you in the last 1 year? Imagine that you had never cut your nails. Draw a picture of your fingers in your notebook showing what it looks like. So, these are all the activities which you have to do. So, this is the end of the lesson. It was quite a lengthy lesson and there was an ample amount of information about flowers and plants. I will also try to share some other videos regarding this topic, so that you may get more clear idea about plants and flowers. And I hope that you all understand this lesson. Thank you. Have a nice day. God bless you all.